Good morning, all of you. So, students, yesterday we have started the chapter that is direct and indirect speech. And in that particular video, I have just begun with this chapter. I have only told you about what a direct speech is and what an indirect speech is. Okay, so now let's begin with the another subheading of this particular chapter. Okay, change in tenses. So how we are going to change, how the tenses change when we are talking about direct and indirect speech, that is we are going to study now. Now we change tenses when reporting in indirect speech. So when you are talking in indirect speech, you change tenses. Okay, when reporting verb is in present tense or simple future tense, the verb in reported speech does not change. So what is happening? We are talking about the verb. When the reporting verb is in simple present tense and simple future tense, simple present tense or simple future tense, then we in indirect speech, that is in a reported speech, verb does not change. For example, Shiva says, I am eating apple pie. So, says here is a reporting verb. It is Shiva is saying something. So, it is a verb. And what? In simple present tense, says that I am eating apple pie. So, says is simple present tense. So, if the verb, reporting verb, is in simple present tense, then the indirect speech, the verb in indirect speech does not change. For example, when you are writing this statement in indirect speech, it would become Shiva says that he is eating apple pie. Okay. Another example. Brijesh will say, I am not well and cannot exert myself. So, say is what? Simple future tense. The verb say is in simple future tense. And then also we don't change the verb in reported speech, that is indirect speech. So, Brijesh will say that he is not well and cannot exert himself. Okay. Another thing about change in tenses, when the reporting verb is in past tense, the verb in reported speech is changed into corresponding past tense. Means when the verb, reporting verb, past tense, okay, is in past tense, then verb is changed, okay, changes into corresponding past tense, okay. Corresponding past. Now, the example is, the girl said, I am scared of monsters. So, example, this is direct speech, okay? We are going to convert this sentence, into indirect speech. So, the statement is, Rita said, or the girl said, the girl said what? I am scared of monsters. Okay, I am scared of monsters. So, said is what? Said is a verb in past tense. Said is a verb in past tense. So when we are going to change this sentence into indirect speech, the sentence would become the girl said that she was scared of what? Of monsters. The girl said that she was scared of monsters. Okay, that she was scared of monsters. Is it clear to all of you? So this I am, why this I am is changing into was? Because the verb is in past tense. This verb is in past tense, so I am would also be changing into past tense. You can't say that the girl said I am. You can't say when you are changing the verb, when you are changing the sentence into past tense and the verb is changed into past tense, you can't say that the girl says that I am. Okay, this sentence would become an incorrect sentence. So you would write what? Said that she was scared of monsters. I hope it is clear to you. I'm rubbing this off right now. If you want, you can take down the screenshot. Okay, so I'm rubbing this off now. Okay, now the third part. The reporting verb is in past tense. जो reporting verb होती हैं अगर वो past tense में होती हैं जैसे said या told. Verb change in indirect speech as follows. So is, am, are will change to when the reporting verb is in past tense. So the verb is, am, are would change into was, were. Then was, were would change into had been. Had been is changing into there is no change. Had been, no change. Okay, so all of you like this. What? Has, have becomes had. Had becomes no change. Do become did. Did becomes did. Had done with no change. Do becomes did. Did becomes had done. Had done becomes no change. Will, shall becomes would. Okay. And in some cases, shall would become should. Must becomes had to. And would, should, might, could, ought to. They don't have any sort of change. Please remember this flowchart in your books. Okay. Please keep in mind. Now note the changes in tenses in reported speech. So सिंपल जो आपका डायरेक्ट टेंस जो होगा वो सिंपल प्रेजेंट टेंस में होगा, इनडायरेक्ट आपका चेंज इनटू सिंपल पास्ट टेंस, प्रेजेंट कॉन्टिन्यूस वुड चेंज इनटू पास्ट कॉन्टिन्यूस, प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट वुड चेंज इनटू पास्ट परफेक्ट, प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कॉन्टिन्यूस वुड चेंज इनटू पास्ट परफेक्ट कॉन्टिन्यूस, सिंपल पास्ट वुड चेंज इनटू पास्ट परफेक्ट, पास्ट कॉन्टिन्यूस वुड चेंज इनटू पास्ट परफेक्ट कॉन्टिन्यूस, पास्ट परफेक्ट डू नॉट चेंज, पास्ट परफेक्ट कॉन्टिन्यू डू नॉट चेंज, विल चेंज इनटू वुड शैल इनटू शुड कैन इनटू कुड मे इनटू माइट. When we refer to universal truths or habituals, etc., the tenses does not change. When you are talking about what? When you are talking about the universal truth or habitual action, then the verb does not, then the tense does not change. I'm hoping that up till now it is clear to all of you what is being taught in direct and in indirect speech, how we are going to convert this sentence. There is use of tenses here, that how we are using a past tense, simple past tense, simple present tense, how these things are taking place. Now, for example, Rohini said to her mother, the lady have been making pickles for 10 years. Mohini told me told her mother that the ladies had been making pickles for 10 years. Okay, so Mohini told her mother that the ladies had been making pickle for 10 years. So here this is direct speech. And have been making, sorry, it is have been, not had been, okay? It is have been making pickles for 10 years. So this is direct speech. It is a present perfect continuous. Have been making, so present perfect continuous. Now then we have to write the same sentence into indirect speech or reported speech. ठीक है? Mohini told her mother that the ladies had been making pickles for 10 years. So, what is being said here? Past perfect tense changes into past perfect continuous. So, Mohini told her mother that the ladies had been making pickles for 10 years. The verb had been making is in past perfect continuous. It would change into had been making. And what? It is written in past perfect continuous. Had been making is changing into past perfect continuous. I hope it is clear to all of you. Now we are going to talk about some important facts. Okay, so now I am rubbing this off. Now, some important facts. So, important fact, there are three situations in which each of the reporting verb is in past tense. We do not change the tenses in the reported speech. Now, the reported speech expresses a universal truth or habitual fact. So, the teacher said to us, the water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Direct and indirect universal truth. The teacher told us that water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Okay. The reported speech expresses, what does reported speech expresses? It expresses a universal truth or habitual habit. So, the teacher said to us that water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. So, it is universal truth or also a habitual fact. The teacher told us that the water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Now, the reported speech has two clauses, both in the past. Okay. Both in the past. How are these tenses? Tenses are used in the last. Reena said to me, Neha was tired, so she didn't go to play with friends. Reena said to me, Neha was tired, so she didn't go out to play with friends. So when you are going to write this answer in indirect speech, what you are going to write? Reena told me that Neha was tired, so she didn't go out to play with friends. Totally a different meaning. Okay. Reena said Neha was tired, so she didn't go out to play with friends. So what the reply of Reena is? Reena told me that Neha was tired. She didn't go out to play with friends. Now the last one. The reported speech describes a situation which still consists of the speech is reported here. Mr. Gupta said all the flights are delayed due to heavy rain. Mr. Gupta said that all the flights are delayed due to heavy rain. Now we are going to talk about say and tell. Okay. We are going to talk about say and tell. Now, we always say something but we tell somebody. Reena said that she was reading a book. So, Reena told me that she was reading a book. Okay. So, the answer is Reena said that she was revealing a book. Okay, so what is being said here? We always say something but we tell somebody. Okay, now let's move on to the stanza. Reena said that she was reading a book. So Reena said that Neha was tired, Neha was tired, Reena said that the Neha was tired. Okay. Wait a second. I'm writing a wrong sentence. So, what is being said here? Rita said that she was reading a book. Okay, so Rita said that she was reading a book. To this, indirect speech would become Rina told me that she was reading a book. Okay, so Rita said that she was reading a book. An indirect speech would become Rina told me that she was reading a book. What I have written, reading a book. Am I clear? Now please take down the screenshot, students. All of you students, please take down the screenshot. Okay, so I'm hoping you have taken down the screenshot, so I'm rubbing this off now. Okay, students, so beta, we would be continuing this chapter in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.